Hello viewers, I am Dr. Ajay Kumar Mishra, welcoming you all to my YouTube channel named Computer the Way of Life. Hope you all are fine with your family and friends and abiding by the guiding principles of first on lockdown period. In this session, we will discuss about the topic Big Data Analysis and Overview. Friends, you all will be agreed with me that with the introduction of internet, the business horizon has increased in many folds. The exponential growth in transactional data created with chronological transaction processing cannot be handled by normal tools. The concept of big data emerged with the introduction of internet that can meet the challenges of bulk data. It is the most widely used technology used in almost every aspect of human life, like business, stock market, bioinformatics, economics and government functioning. Before discussing more about the term big data, we must have a clear concept regarding this. Big data can be defined as a set of extremely large data that is unorganized and complex in nature. It defies the concept of conventional or common database management methods that were designed. Big data sets cannot be dealt with traditional database management system and tools. They do not fit into regular database networks. Normally, one works on data of size kilobyte or megabyte when they have to deal with the Word document or Excel files, or maximum in gigabyte or in terabytes when they have to deal with movies or coding. But when they have to deal with the data in petabytes, that is 2 to the power 50 bytes, or 10 to the power 15 bytes, or exabyte, that is 2 to the power 60 bytes, or zettabytes, that is 2 to the power 70 bytes, that is 10 to the power 21 byte in size or more, is called big data. As a whole, one can say that big data is the field which extract and analyze values from the volume. The concept of big data can be better explained with the following diagrams. Here, figure 1 describes the stages of big data analysis, whereas figure 2 describes the life cycle of big data analysis. With the diagram, one can observe that the concept of big data is coined with the collection of data to its proper selection by using different types of sampling techniques. Then the target data are pre-processed for removing the noisy data, and then the selected data is transferred to its suitable form as per the requirement. The data finally available in its required form is mined to generate patterns. Patterns are interpreted and evaluated to generate rules. Rules then satisfy the threshold value greater than the minimum support and confidence level, subsequently leads to knowledge. To understand how big data is created, we can take an example. Each time we use an application on our phone or computer or any other electronic gadgets and visits a web page, signs up online on a platform, or even types into a search engine, a piece of data is gathered, whereas we are completely ignorant about it. Now imagine the number of people spending time on the internet, visiting different web pages, uploading pictures and whatnot. All of these adds up to the stockpile of big data. It's a time to discuss about the sources of big data. Nowadays, most of our daily activities are depending on lots of preloaded data, and while using them, creating a large number of transactional data. Common sources of big data are weather station, telecom company, social networking site, share market and e-commerce. In case of weather station, we know all the weather station and satellite generate very huge data which are stored and manipulated to forecast weather by the meteorological department. In case of telecom companies, different telecom companies like BSNL, Airtel, Vodafone, Reliance and many more study the data of its millions of users to find trends and accordingly publish their plan. Next, social networking site. As we know, widely used networking sites like Facebook, WhatsApp, Google, LinkedIn generate huge amount of data on a day-to-day basis as they have billions of users worldwide. Next, share market. Stock exchange across the world generates huge amount of data through its daily transaction. that can be used to get the trend value. In case of e-commerce sites like Amazon, Flipkart, Alibaba and many more generate huge number of logs for which users' buying trend can be traced. Next, characteristics of big data. Data set is termed as big data if it includes the three basic characteristics like volume, variety and velocity, termed as 3 V's of big data. As the concept of big data emerges in a dynamic environment, new terms are also added like veracity, value, visualization, viscosity, virality, and in future more terms may be included. These terms play significant role in data handling environment. Characteristics of big data are volume, velocity, variety, veracity, value, visualization, viscosity, virality, and complexity. When we are talking about the term volume, organizations have to constantly scale their storage solution since big data clearly requires large amount of space to be stored. In case of velocity, since big data is being generated every second, organizations need to respond in real time to deal with it. In case of variety, big data comes in different forms. It could be structured or unstructured, or even in different formats such as text format, videos, images, and more. In case of veracity, big data can contain noisy or wrong data. Uncertainty of data is something organizations have to consider while dealing with big data. Volume refers just collecting big data and storing it has no consequences unless the data is analyzed and a useful output is produced. Visualization means displaying the pictorial representation of the facts as a nutshell, which is more easier to understand. Viscosity refers the resistance to flow in volume of data that can come from different data sources. Virality describes how quickly information gets dispersed across people-to-people networks. And in case of complexity, big data are complex in nature and difficult to extract the desired value from it is not always possible. Now we will discuss about the applications of big data. Big data is a powerful source that makes things easy. The primary goal of big data analytics is to help business communities to provide timely, detailed, and appropriate information that enables the decision makers to make proper decisions. Commonly used application areas of big data: government, technology, fraud detection, banking, agriculture, social media analysis, call center analysis, advertisement and marketing, telecom, and healthcare. Now we will discuss one after another details. First, government. The success of e-government is solely depending on the big data analysis. Through this, the government agencies ascertain how the citizens are responding to government action as well as gaining ideas for policy argumentation. Next, technology. Technology helps to deal with huge amount of transactional data and to draw inferences in favor of their business. For example, Hadoop, eBay, Amazon, Facebook, Flipkart use millions of consumer data, analyze them, basing on consumers' recommendations and merchandise, and subsequently used for cross-marketing, floor management, better customer satisfaction, and for other future avenues. Next, fraud detection. Detecting the fraud in real time is very important in areas that involve online transaction processing. Big data analysis analyzes the claims at real time by identifying the patterns during transactions by detecting anomaly behavior of user and can prevent before it occurs. Then banking. It describes the distribution of consumers' data, that is earning, saving, mortgage, insurance policies, and medical data, and outsourcing of data analysis reveals the sensitive data. This amplifies the security risk and leads to privacy issues that discourage customers. Next, agriculture. Biotechnology firms use sensor data to optimize crop efficiency. For this, they are planting text crop to record and store the data about how crops react to various factors like temperature, water levels, soil consumption, growth, and gene sequencing of each plant in the test bed. This helps to plan for crop plantation accordingly. Next, social media analysis. Social media has revolutionized the field of big data. It provides valuable real-time insights into how the market is responding to products and campaigns. This helps the companies to adjust their pricing, promotion, campaign, and placements accordingly. Then, call center analysis. Call centers are a great barometer and influencer of market sentiment. Big data analysis can help to identify recurring problems of customer and staff behavior patterns of the fly by capturing and processing call content items. Next, advertising and marketing. Advertising agencies are using facial recognition software to analyze the big data that helps them to understand the patterns of user behavior and then gather information about customers' motivation, subsequently help marketers to create ads most likely to go viral and improve sales. Then, telecom. Telecom sectors are using big data analysis to deal with upcoming market demands. The service providers and operators are using new set of data management and analysis capabilities to make accurate decisions by taking into the number of customers, network context, and other critical aspects of their business without overloading their networks and keeping their running cost. Then finally, we will discuss about healthcare. Traditional healthcare depends on individuals' decision by using their own clinical judgment rather than relying on protocols based on big data. Most of the times, important informations remain unnoticed because organizations lack procedures for integrating data and communicating findings. Healthcare stakeholders now have access to new threads of knowledge that helps to deal with complexity, diversity, and timeliness. After having a detailed discussion regarding the big data analysis, it's a time to discuss about its opportunities. Extracting the knowledge from the big data are the most important skill that is in high demand nowadays. The trend shows the demand in these areas won't be dropping down in near future and opening up multiple doors of opportunities for us. Some of the hot job profiles are given below. Data scientist, data analyst, data architect, big data engineers, and database managers. The basic responsibility of data scientist is to mine the data sources and use algorithms and machine learning techniques, whereas data analysts are responsible to analyze and interpret data, visualize it, and build reports to help and make better business decisions. Data architects are responsible to design database systems and tools. The duty of big data engineers is to design, maintain, and provide supports to big data solutions. Finally, database managers are responsible for control database systems, their performance, perform troubleshooting, and upgrade hardware and software. While talking about big data, we cannot ignore the challenges associated with it. The common and obvious challenges are rapid data growth. As we have to work in a dynamic environment, more and more data is generated every now and then, which creates challenges to find insights from it. It is also difficult to select the data that is actually relevant and useful for further analysis. Then, storage. Huge amount of data is difficult to store and manage without appropriate tools, technologies, and proper exposure in the concerned field. Then, thinning across data sources. This is also referred as transformation of data to its suitable form as per the requirement. This implies that when organizations import data from different sources, the data from one source might not be up to date as compared to the data from another source. Then, security. Large amount of data can be an easy target for advanced persistent threats. So, here lies another challenge for organizations to keep their data secure by proper authentication, data encryption, and other methods available. Then, unreliable data. Big data is a central repository where data from different sources are coming. You cannot ensure that the big data is 100% correct. It might contain redundant or incomplete data along with contradictions. Then, integrity. The different sources from where the data is coming to the big data are not authenticated, that lead to unreliable and subsequently their integrity is doubtful. Then skill and talent availability, highly skilled and professional attitude is required to extract the hidden tendency and patterns in the large data set, which is not possible by the common user. And finally, expenses involved. Availability of data in time and its proper processing with accuracy involve lot of resources like cost, time, memory, manpowers that require high expenses, which cannot be met by the small organizations. Finally, we will discuss about the technologies and tools used in big data. Big data analysis perform computations on huge data sets and on multiple systems in a parallel fashion. There are many technologies available to deal with big data. Among them, few are described below, such as Hadoop, MongoDB, Hive, Spark, HBase, Cassandra, Kafka, and many more. Here, Hadoop is a software framework that evaluates structured and unstructured data and works on high availability distributed object-oriented platform. It was developed by Doug Cutting and Mike Caffarella in 2005. It can virtually handle infinite coexisting tasks and offers huge storage for a variety of data. Then MongoDB. MongoDB was founded in 2007 by Dwight Merriman, Elliot Horowitz, and Kevin Ryan. It is an agile, open-source document database having cross-platform compatible, mostly used for high scalability, obtainability, and better presentation. Then Hive. Hive was initially developed by Facebook and subsequently other companies like Netflix and Financial Industry Regulatory Authority were also involved. It is a data warehouse tool built on Hadoop platform. Then Spark. Apache Spark is one of the major open source projects for data processing. It was initially started by Matti Zaharia at UC Berkeley's AMP lab in 2009 and open sourced in 2010. Spark supports the languages like Python, R, Java, and Scala. Then HBase. HBase is an open source non-relational distributed database offering real-time read and write provision to large datasets written in Java. It is developed as a part of Apache Software Foundation's Apache Hadoop project and runs on top of HDFC, that is a Hadoop distributed file system. Then Cassandra. Apache Cassandra is a top-notch Apache project with its origin at Facebook. It is effective for management of large chunks of data. Cassandra offers the benefits like latency, fault permissive, regionalization, proficient sustenance, robustness, flexibility, and scalability. And finally, Kafka. Kafka is also an open source, partitioned, scalable, flaw permissive, highly swift, distributed, and secure platform. It performs as a bridge between several key open source systems like Spark, NIFI, and the third-party tools. With this, I remain. Hope you all have enjoyed it. Thank you for your patient hearing. Also suggest the topic of interest you want to explain me in future.